I'm a scripting guru, like a couple of guys I met in the back of the room over there. That's cool, because we have the advanced category. Now, every year, at least the last 3 years I've been doing the scripting games, at least one of my advanced events gets a little carried away. So this year was no exception. I think that I had one event that I think only like 7 people in the world completed. So I try to balance it out a little bit, you know. But there again, you know, those are designed, you know, at the more advanced level, you know, and so we have higher expectations for you. Go to the Scripting Guy blog, which we will do over here really quick. So this is the Script Center. Teresa has cards in the back. She also has PowerShell stickers for you. So make sure that you see her before you leave during your break or what have you. Can get to this by going to scriptingguys.com and then just do /blog, or, you know, just actually, you know, go to the Script Center and then click on blog. This is the blog. And this is something that I'm really, 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 really proud of. Take a look at this right here. 1,075 articles about Windows PowerShell.
Right. Yeah.
Take a look at this. 1,049 articles about VBScript. Yeah. All right. So, but if you go to like Windows PowerShell, this will take you to all the PowerShell articles. And then this is a tag cloud, and you can scroll your way through here if you want to. So, for instance, I was talking with somebody about group policy and PowerShell earlier. PowerShell, group policy, right there. So that'll take you to the articles that I wrote about using Windows PowerShell with group policy. If thing's bigger, you know, then that means there's more articles. If it's smaller, it means there's fewer articles. That's kind of the idea. I have a link to the 2011 scripting games right there. And there are some very, very good resources on here. And, by the way, if you would like to design the 2012 logo, shoot me an email.
Yes.
Or send me something on Twitter. I'm going to open this up as soon as I get approval from legal to do so. I decided, hey, dude, this is a community event, so why not let the community design the logo? So it's going to be cool as soon as I get permission from legal to do so. And by the way, dude, also dudette. You know, I don't mean to like, you know, leave anybody out there. So now, if we come down here, I want to show you this. This is something that's really cool. So even if you missed the games, there is one resource here that you should absolutely positively come over here and take a look at. And this is the 2011 Scripting Game Study Guide. Okay? I gave links for everything on the 10 domains that I tested. Okay? It's a really, really, really cool thing. You can read the Scripting Wife articles. Those are for beginners, and they're very, very step-by-step oriented. They're really, really, they're fun. They're kind of like a little hilarious too. The other thing that I want to show you over here is I have the, actually there's a couple things, so I lied. Learn PowerShell tab. The Learn PowerShell tab has a series of 5 hours of video sessions that I recorded right before Tech Ed 2011. These were also for the basics of learning Windows PowerShell. So these are a really good resource. Something that's fun to do is to take the PowerShell quiz. And I think I put 25 or 30 questions on here. So it'll pick out like 20 questions and test you on them. If you get it right or if you get it wrong, there's a link to articles, in most cases Scripting Wife articles, that cover that particular topic, and you could read it for additional information on it. That's actually pretty cool, right over there. The scripts, the community tab. The community tab is really, really cool. I have a listing of where I'm going to be and what I'm going to be working at and talking with and all that kind of stuff. See, AZPosh right there. Woo! There is the user group map. And Teresa and I are working really hard on trying to find people and help them to fill in this map. And so we leave here, we're heading up towards Pittsburgh, where that meeting, if it's not sold out, it is almost sold out. And that's going to be their very first PowerShell user group meeting in Pittsburgh. It's going to be cool. The guy that's running that, Ken, is a really cool dude, and his wife's really nice, too. But anyway, so that's there. Charlotte is having their first meeting in January. And so that's going to be cool. So this is a neat place to come and to look and to try to find an area. You might be traveling. You may wind up in Charlotte or something, have a long layover. You know, if you're in luck, you might be able to pop over to the Charlotte PowerShell Users Group. We'd love to see you. You know about the script repository. There's a lot of scripts on here, 6,100 scripts. You want to look at how there's 1,500 PowerShell scripts and 3,700 VB scripts. So we've got a ways to go on PowerShell scripts. So if you write a good script, upload it to the script repository. We need it. Okay, I'll be glad if the next time I'm out here, I can say we have more PowerShell scripts than VB scripts. And we're looking at maybe in March or something, you know, for that. The last thing that I want to make absolutely certain that I tell you about is to keep your eyes and your ears peeled. We'll put announcements on the community page. I'll write about it on the Scripting Guy blog. But we're planning the very first ever PowerShell Saturday in Columbus, Ohio. It's going to be a free event. It'll be all day, have multiple tracks, and should be some really, really cool stuff. So we're working on that with the Columbus PowerShell Users Group to sponsor it, to host it, and you'll be hearing more about that soon. So that'll be a lot of fun. Okay, enough advertising. So let's get started. Okay, what we're going to do I decided to ditch my PowerPoint slide deck. I don't believe that I need to use PowerPoint to teach PowerShell.
Oh, yeah.
So I ditched PowerPoint. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to use PowerShell to talk about PowerShell. Now, theoretically, my talk is about Windows PowerShell best practices. So I believe that it's a best practice that you shouldn't just waste your time writing scripts. Okay? There are times in which a quick one-off type of script is worthwhile. But most of the time what I find is that if I write a script, a little bit later I'm coming back and I'm needing to use it again. And this script has hard-coded literal values in it. You know, you have to come in, and every time you run it, you got to edit it and make changes to it. And if it's 2 or 3 months later, I've forgotten what changes I need to make. You know, and so it's just kind of an annoyance. And so my theme is don't write scripts, write modules. Now, what I'm going to do, how many of you have been writing modules? Just a couple of you, okay? Now, when I get done with this, every one of you, we're going to rush out, and you're going to want to start writing modules, okay? Now, why have you not been writing modules? Confusing? Sounds scary? Yeah? Ooh. Too developer-y, geeky thing, you know? So, think you're going to, you know, start to like withdraw, you know, your boss will lock you in an office and slide pizza under the door, you know, turn you into a developer geek.
The unholy ones.
Yeah. But that's not it, okay? So what I want to do is I'm going to show you how to do a module, okay? So here's my outline. We're going to start off with a single command. We're going to put that command into a function. We're going to turn that function into an advanced function. We're going to put that function into a module. I'm going to install the module. I'm going to modify the module and update the module. I'm going to create a module manifest, and then everything will be groovy. Okay? Now, along the way, I'm going to show you the advantages of a module. Okay, now, there are two places. Actually, there's more than that, but you know, just for the sake of argument right now. There's two main places that you can put a module, and PowerShell will immediately know where it's at. One is in, you know, Windows System 32, Windows PowerShell V1, blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Dude, that's no good. Why? You have to have admin rights to write to System 32, Windows, blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, and best practices, we don't run with admin rights. Okay, we run with least privilege. Okay, least privilege dudes and dudettes have the ability to put it in their documents and settings folder. We always have rights to our documents and settings folder, no matter how locked down we may or may not be. Okay? Now, if I put a module in this location, then I can just use PowerShell and say, find my modules. And it finds them. And the commands are immediately available. Now, on my computer that I've got at home, the one that I use most of the time, yeah, and I've got like a dozen computers, but the one I use most of the time, it's got a C drive, it's got an E drive, it's got an F drive, it's got two other drives. It's got like six or seven drives. And the past 5 years, I've written 3,000 or 4,000 PowerShell scripts. Some of which are on my old laptop probably and didn't get copied to my new laptop, which then became my old laptop and then left stuff that didn't get copied to the other new laptop. And forget about them being on my main computer I use every day. But if I have them in a modules directory, PowerShell knows where they are. And I can get access to this information. All right. So, enough advertising. Let's get to work. So, clear the screen. Okay. Bye-bye. All right. So, I like to use WMI. I wrote the book on WMI. So, Windows PowerShell does WMI.
Because he did write the book on WMI. I mean, come on, guys. That was hilarious.
All right, so get WMI object. PowerShell does WMI so well, it's like ridiculous. So get WMI object win32_bios, okay? Now, I run this script, and it returns a bunch of information, okay, about the BIOS on this computer. Hey, that's pretty handy. Because I already said I got a dozen computers at home. You probably have more than that at work. From time to time, you probably need to update the BIOS on those machines. You need a report. Oh, we can install SMS. Oh, wait, SMS isn't supported anymore. What's it now? System Center Configuration Manager. Oh, dude, you know, you got to like have a stuff to do this, you know? So, dude, we can do it in PowerShell. No problem. All right, so this is really cool. Now, I can add a computer name parameter, and I can type in lots of remote computers, such as localhost and loopback, and I can even do an IP address. Saw a t-shirt one time that said there's no place like 127.0.0.1. Like, what a nerd, right? I thought it was pretty cool. See? So this is cool. We just did this with an array of different computers. Now, this is neat. This is useful. But guess what? I give this to the help desk. Now the help desk wants me to give them rights to open up the ISE, teach them how to use this, and then hope that they don't mess things up too badly while they edit this.